Trump makes school great again, gives back popular drink Michelle stole from kids. There's no doubt that kids all over the United States are sick and tired of Michelle Obama's gross school lunches. Now, President Donald Trump's administration has delivered a major blow to the lunch program by putting chocolate milk back on the menu. On Thursday, the U.S. Department of Agriculture issued a new rule that softens the limits of sodium intake, fat content in milk and relaxes whole grain requirements, according to ABC News. Translation? Good-tasting, flavored milk is coming back. To be more specific, chocolate milk with 1% fat will be returning to school cafeterias across America. Chocolate or flavored milk that wasn't non-fat was banned for years under the Obamas. This is not reducing the nutritional standards whatsoever, Agriculture Secretary Sonny Perdue told reporters in May, according to ABC. Flexibility in schools is coming back, which is definitely needed. The strict guidelines that Michelle Obama favored have tied the hands of schools for years. In a statement last week, Perdue slammed the centralized planning that led to so many lunches going to waste because students had no interest in eating them. Schools need flexibility in menu planning so they can serve nutritious and appealing meals, he said. Schools want to offer food that students actually want to eat. It doesn't do any good to serve nutritious meals if they wind up in the trash can. Perdue is absolutely right. The National School Lunch Program as it developed during the Obama years was a disaster. The strict calorie and sugar restrictions have made school lunches small and tasteless. It's even been reported that some kids are walking away from their lunches hungry and malnourished from the unpopular school meals. How much waste has there been in school cafeterias across the United States because kids absolutely hate the food being offered to them? In addition, according to the School Nutrition Association, Michelle's program added an extra 27 cents to every breakfast. Of course, the local school districts, and their taxpayers, were stuck absorbing the costs. Sure, kids should be eating food that's nutritious for them, but that doesn't mean it has to be government mandated, taste bad, or be in extremely small portions. Unfortunately, Michelle never learned this lesson. Fortunately, the Trump administration is changing the rules.